Welcome back to another episode of SmartHacks. My name is Gary, and in today's episode, I want to show you how to render yourself as a famous painting using Adobe Character Animator's newest feature called Characterizer. Here's a quick peek. Recent advances in AI technology are paving the way for digital artists to experiment with some amazing visual techniques. The software is able to analyze a painting or drawing and replicate the style to make your photo look like it was hand-painted by that artist. How cool is that? If you've got Adobe Creative Cloud installed, there should be an update available for Character Animator. If you don't see a notification, simply restart your computer and check again. Once it's updated, the new start screen includes a link to Characterizer. The first thing we need to do is capture our face and record a few mouth shapes. While there is a guided feature, I found I get better results by clicking the drop-down below the Create New Capture button and select Manual Capture. It's important that the lighting on your face be even from the front without side shadows. You also want to have a clutter-free background. Follow the instructions at the bottom of your screen and click the Capture button after each pose. Once it's finished processing, you can apply different styles and play with the various settings. You can also click through each of your face poses using the left and right arrows on the side preview. The stylization slider controls how strongly the effect is applied to your face. Feature exaggeration distorts your head shape and position of your eyes and mouth. If you enabled head turns at the bottom, Characterizer will automatically produce the corresponding left and right quarter profiles, but that disables feature exaggeration. The Cycles drop-down menu controls the number of frames used for each head position for a more progressive animated effect. Keep in mind that this affects processing time. I leave resolution set at 480 since I don't normally need a larger avatar. The quality dropdown has the highest effect on processing time, so only increase this once you're happy with the overall preview. Click the Head Only box if you don't need your character's neck or background to display. When you're happy with the results, click the Generate Puppet button in the upper right corner and wait for it to finish processing. Now, enable your webcam and you can see real-time face tracking with your stylized face. Now let's create our own style by importing a photo. I thought it would be fun to have the face of an angel, so I searched online and found this image of the Archangel Michael. I saved it to my desktop, then select my face capture, then clicked Create New Style. The morph points for the nose and mouth need to be realigned. The guide on the left is sort of helpful. The points need to line up exactly, otherwise you'll get weird stretched results. Make sure the pupils don't intersect with the shape lines for the eyes. Also, if you notice parts of the stylized puppet are getting scrunched, try spacing your morph points more evenly, or closer to well-defined areas of contrast. One improvement to the software I would make here is to show a preview of our own face on the left, and highlight each corresponding dot as we align them on the masked image. This is how most 2D face morphing programs work. Also, keyboard shortcuts should be unified with Photoshop so that the B key activates the brush and V selects the pointer and Z the zoom tool. Control plus to zoom in or control minus to zoom out would be great. The spacebar does work for the hand tool, as does the Alt key when zooming out. In refining the masked areas, I like to start with the neck because it's usually the simplest shape. Then I cover over any mistakes with bigger brushes. It would be great if brushes also functioned like they do in Photoshop. The mouse scroll wheel does adjust the brush size, but I use a trackball, and I'd like to use left and right bracket keys to change the brush size. I'd also like to be able to hold down the shift key to quickly outline a shape with a small brush, just as I can in Photoshop. Here's what the refined style looks like. Not bad. You'll definitely want to experiment with the stylization slider at 0 and 100%. I created a new style based on the photo of a lion with some interesting results. You can also import static photos to apply styles to, rather than using your face capture. You can't import non-humanoid images, though. Darn. Just for fun, I imported an image that I already used as a style to see what would happen. That's pretty crazy. If you want to share your face cap or styles with anyone, all you have to do is right-click the preview and reveal its location on your computer. Then you can distribute it accordingly. What's the most interesting image you found to use to create a new style? Leave a comment with a link to it below. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please like and subscribe for more videos from SmartHacks, and I'll see you online.